Matt Bonnell from the Oracle Mobile Platform team. Now, a conversation or a dialogue defines a flow in a conversation between a user and a chatbot. And in this video, I'll be introducing Intelligent Bots Dialog Flow, which is how you design and implement logic for your bot to carry out a conversation with the user. So let's begin with a conversation between a user and a chatbot. For example, suppose you have a banking bot and the user wants to check the balance, or maybe you're choosing flowers from a florist. What manages that interaction and how do you program it? What determines the flow between user and bot? Now, the best way to think about how this conversation happens is as a workflow with specific named steps that we call states. You then navigate through the states, do some actions, and maybe conditionally branch based on some factor, and this is the dialogue flow. In terms of how you define the dialogue flow, we do this in the Intelligent Bots Designer, and we configure the flow using a markup language called Oracle Bot Markup Language, which we call BotML for short. So BotML is a rules set implemented in YAML, which is a markup language that fundamentally is a way of expressing data and data relationships in a format that's highly focused on human readability. Now, although this format is how you configure dialogue flow today, we are looking into building a visual editor on top to make the dialogue flow creation even easier. However, it will always be useful to understand how the dialogue flow is configured under the covers, even if a graphical user interface is introduced. So let's take a close look at the dialogue flow in BotML and really understand what we have in terms of building blocks and how it works when we start to implement our flows. Now here we have a sample dialogue flow defined in BotML. It contains three distinct sections. Here's the header, where we define the bot name and version. Next is the context section, where we define the global variables that will be used in the flow. And finally, we have a states section, where we define the individual steps and actions for the flow. In essence, this is the heart of the logic that defines your flow. Okay, so let's drill in with a little more detail. I mentioned that in the second section of the dialogue flow is the context section. So let's take a look at that more closely. The context provides a global variable scope for the bot. So within the context definition is where you define the variables for your bot. They have a global scope in your bot and they're accessible throughout your dialogue flow. Now the syntax in BotML for defining variables is pretty straightforward. You simply have the variable name without quotes, followed by a colon, and then the variable type, which is in quotes. For example, here we have a variable called payment name, which will be a variable of type string. We might use this as a banking bot to note the details of a payment transaction, for example. The different variable types that you can use in your context include primitive types such as int, string, and boolean, as well as more specialized types such as custom entities such as account type, built-in entities like currency, and the results from the natural language processing engine, which is NLP result. And now we come to the section that's really interesting because it gets to the heart of how we implement the logic of our bot. This is the state section, which holds the steps and the activities that do the actual work for us. Each individual state is going to have one and only one component. And a component is what actually does the work for any given state. So you can see a component for resolving an intent, one for setting a variable, and one for displaying a list. Next, you'll have a number of properties which are specific to the component that's actually being used at that time. For example, a list component has properties for the list choices, the message prompt, and the variable which the user choice is then referenced into. And you can think of a component as a programming method and that the properties are parameters that are being passed to that method. Now, finally, you have a transition, which can be thought of as a navigation part of the state. For example, a transition may allow you to specify a jump to another state or simply go to the next state if a transition has not been actually specified. Now, before we delve further into the details of individual state, let's talk about the default flow within the state section. Now, by default, the flow will proceed from the topmost state to the bottommost state in order, Now that is unless the flow is redirected to a specific state via a transition. Now remember that transitions would typically specify a particular state to navigate to. If a state doesn't specify a transition, then the flow will simply proceed from top to bottom. So every state can have one or more transitions, and like the properties of a state, they're also determined by the component themselves. So transitions come in several types, and we'll go through each of them in turn. One of the first types of transitions that you're likely to find is transition actions. This is because the system.intent component utilizes transition actions, and typically system.intent is the first thing that you will do in your bot to try and determine what it is the user wants to accomplish, their intent, and to navigate to that part of the dialogue flow. So system.intent is going to determine the intent from the input provided by the user, and the action will be to jump to a particular state. So if the intent resolves to balances, then the dialogue jumps to start balances, and the dialogue continues from that point. When a state is the last step in the flow, you may want to exit or restart the conversation. For example, you want to check user's bank balance and it's already checked the balance and returned the appropriate information, so it may be appropriate to exit the flow. And you exit the flow by specifying a return transition. Now note that the name you put after the transition, the return, is by convention the name that you're returning from, the name of the state you're returning from, but it doesn't really matter. This will return from, in this case, print balance, and will reset all of the context variables as well. And once you exit the flow, any further user input will begin back at the top of the flow where they originally started. Now there's another couple of options for transitions. The next transition simply proceeds to the state named in the transition. Use the next keyword as the name of the transition and specify the name of the state that you want to transition to as the value. So in this case, next resolve payment amount will jump to that state and continue executing from there. Now, the error transition type is a special case should the current component encounter some sort of error condition, in which case you can define a specific name state to handle that specific error. So that gives you a basic introduction to dialog flow. Now, I've really just scratched the surface, and we'll have further videos to take you more in depth into the topic, including going over things like the system components. But now, thanks for watching. And I hope you've got a really good understanding of how dialogue flows work in our Intelligent Bots. Thanks for watching.